Dear students, welcome to session 1 of chapter number 2, data representation. So students, now we will be studying about various types of number systems that we are going to use in our computer system. In our computer system, our numbers can be stored in different number system. So we'll be studying about 4 number systems over here. Okay, so the 4 number systems that we'll be studying about are decimal number system, octal number system, hexadecimal number system and binary number system. So let's take them one by one. So first of all, the decimal number system. As from the very beginning, from our first class, we are actually studying about the decimal number system only. This number system has the base 10. Right? That means what? That we have in totality 10 numbers or 10 symbols to represent our number. So, and those 10 numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on till 9. Right? So, all the numbers that we write, actually they are of the form, they will just be comprised of these symbols only, 0 to 9. So let's take an example here. Let's take the example of 2,48,901, right? So this is a number which is actually a decimal number because it comprises of numbers from 0 to 9 only, right? And here you can see that this number, the rightmost number, actually is the least significant digit over here, or LSD here, and the leftmost number, that is 2, is the most significant digit, right? So we can see over here, like I've told 2,48,901. How we are going to write it? We'll be writing it with base 10. This is base 10. Okay, so if we just write the number in blocks, so how we are going to write 2,48,901? Right, so this is the least significant digit, as I've told you. So this will be actually the zeroth element. Okay, this is at the zeroth location, first location, second location, third, fourth and fifth location. So how to write it in expanded form? You all have done in your junior classes about the expanded form notation, right? So 2 into 10 to the power 5, whatever the number appears over here, plus 4 into 10 to the power 4, plus 8 into 10 to the power 3, plus 9 into 10 to the power 2, plus 0 into 10 to the power 1, and plus 1 into 10 to the power 0. As you all know, anything to the power 0 is 1. So 1 into 1 becomes 1. 0 into 10 becomes 0. 9 into 10 square, that is 900. So now every number is at its proper place. Okay, now let's take another example here, 256.238 to the base 10. How we are going to represent it? 256.238. Okay, so as I've told you, this is the least significant digit, right? So this is at position 0, 1 and 2. And what about the positions of the elements, the numbers that are after the decimal place? So their position will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Got that? Now how to take out the, write them in the expanded form? Just have a look. 256.238. So 2 into 10 to the power 2. 5 into 10 to the power 1 plus 6 into 10 to the power 0, 2 into 10 to the power minus 1 plus 3 into 10 to the power minus 2 plus 8 into 10 to the power minus 3. Okay, so this is how we are going to write it. 10 to the power minus 1 is 1 upon 10 to the power 1. 10 to the power minus 2 is 1 upon 10 square. 10 to the power minus 3 is 1 upon 10 cube. This is how we can write them, write the number in expanded form. Okay. Now we come to the second number system, that is octal number system. Octal means what? Octal means 8. Right. So that means what? That in this number system, we have digits from 0 to 7. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this makes out 8 numbers. 8 symbols. So that means all the numbers, when we are writing a number in octal number system, all the numbers will be taking these numbers only, 0 to 7 numbers only. And octal number system has the base 8. Okay, like 356 to the base 8. Is it correct? Is it an octal number? Yes, because why? It is because all these numbers are between 0 to 7 only, right? So this is the correct octal number. Now let's see another number, 459. So is it a correct octal number? No, it is not, because 9 actually is out of range of these numbers 0 to 7. We can just use numbers between 0 to 7, and 9 is a different number. So, we cannot write 459 for an octal number. Okay, now I'll just tell you how to convert an octal number to decimal number form. We can convert one number from one number system to another number system. Okay, so equivalent of 357.236, which is an octal number here, and we have to represent it into decimal form, that is in the form of base 10. Okay, so what this number will be, if we are going to write it in expanded form, it will be 3 into 8 square plus 5 into 8 to the power 1 plus 7 into 8 to the power 0. Okay, next 2 into 8 to the power minus 1 plus 3 into 8 to the power minus 2 plus 6 into 8 to the power minus 3. Now, when we are going to just expand it, 8 square is 64, 8 to the power 1 is 8 itself, 8 to the power 0 is 1. Similarly, we are going to expand these numbers also, and after calculations, we get a number which is actually in the base 10 case. Okay, so this is our decimal equivalent of this number. Next, we come to hexadecimal number system. Hexadecimal means what? Hex means 6 and decimal means 10. So, 6 plus 10, that is 16. So, that means a hexadecimal number system has the base 16. So, what all symbols we are going to use here? Because in decimal system, we have 0 to 9 numbers, right? These are total 10 numbers. Okay, now what next 6 numbers we'll be using? We'll be using over here the alphabets. Alphabets A to F. A is representing 10. B represents 11 here. C 12, D 13, E 14, and F is 15. Okay, so this is our hexadecimal number system. 0 to 9 and then A to F. Okay. So, over here, like this is the number 249AF. This is base 16. That means it's a hexadecimal number. Now, in the next case, 1283. If we just write 1283, now we are not able to understand which number system this number is representing. It can be a decimal number system. It can be a hexadecimal system. But by looking at the base, we can understand here, because the base is 16. So it is a hexadecimal number. Okay. Next we come to binary number system. So binary, as we have already studied in the previous chapter also, binary means 2. Okay. So in this number system, we have the base 2 only, and symbols that we are going to use over here are 0 and 1. Okay, our computer understands binary language. So this number system is also very important for us to study. So any number in the binary number system will comprise of only zeros and ones. Okay, this is base 2 and this is the number in the binary form. Now, we'll just study how to convert one number from one number system to another, right? we have now learned about all four different types of number systems. Now we'll be just studying how to convert one number from one number system to another, right? So in the first case, we'll be studying about conversion of a decimal number to binary form, right? So this is our decimal number, let's suppose 2453 to the base 10, and now we have to convert this into binary form, in the base 2 form. So what we will be doing is, we are going to divide 2453, whatever the number is given here, this number is going to be divided by 2. Why 2? Because the binary number system has the base 2. So that is why we are going to divide this number with 2. Okay, so we have just divided it. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 2s are 4, 1 goes here, and 2 6s are 12. So 1 is the remainder, and we are going to write the remainder here. Okay, similarly 2 6s are 12, 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6, no remainder is there, so we write 0. 2 3s are 6, so zeros are, then 6 are 12, again 1 is the remainder, so we'll write 1 here. 2 1s are 2, it becomes 10. 2 5s are 10, 2 3s are 6, no remainder is there, so we write 0. Similarly, we are going to divide the whole number by 2 only, okay, each time with 2, and we are going to write the remainder, whatever is left, okay. Now, at the end, we just reached 2 1s are 2, okay. Now, this is our most significant bit over here, and this is our least significant bit. So what, how we are going to write our number in binary form, we'll start from here, okay. This will be our leftmost bit, and this is going to be the rightmost bit. So we are going to write the number from here till here. So the number will be 10100010001, okay, to the base 2. So 2453 with base 10 is actually this with base 2. Okay, have you understood? So will you be doing two more questions for this? Let's suppose 856, and we have to convert this to binary form. And one more number, let's suppose 28675. This is base 10 number, and we have to convert this to base 2, right? So I just want you all to do these conversions, okay? Now I'll meet you in the next session. Thank you and have a nice day.